And we are moving ahead with knowing some more facts about evolution, right? So in the last class, we had stopped and we had to start with, if I'm not wrong, geological scale, right? So let us see. I think you all have received the PPTs in your WhatsApp chat, in your group. So you can definitely go ahead with it. Yes. Well, so in the last class, we had stopped on this earlier slide. Just check if I'm wrong. This we completed in the last class, na? Like how the diversified, organisms are basically coming out from the same ancestral history. So we have seen this tree, if I'm not wrong, right? So now we have to go ahead with the geological time scale. Now, yeah. So let us come to the geological time scale. The total lifespan of Earth from the time of its origin is going to be called as the geological time. Okay. Now, what is this geological time? So, it's basically the time period or the span, as we say, from what? From the origin of the Earth, okay, to the time of origin of these organisms. Okay. That is how the geological time scale is, what we say. Devised, right? So the total lifespan of the Earth from the time of its origin is going to be the geological time scale. Okay, about 2000 million years ago, first cellular forms of life appeared on Earth. Now, till that, till we came to this particular slide, what we have understood, there are so many scientists who have put forward their versions of describing how Earth evolved, how life evolved, and so on. So, looking at those, concepts that modern synthetic theory came into existence, which we saw in detail, right? Now, according to this particular modern synthetic theory and the previous knowledge of different scientists put forward, it has been calculated that approximately about 2000 MYA. MYA आपके एग्जाम में यही एब्रिविएशन आएगा फॉर मिलियन ईयर्स अगो. ओके, सो हियर यू कैन सी 500 MYA. सो MYA स्टैंड्स फॉर मिलियन ईयर्स अगो. ओके, डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज इफ इट कम्स इन योर एग्जाम एज MY. सो अबाउट 2000 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो फर्स्ट सेलुलर फॉर्म्स ऑफ लाइफ अपीयर्ड ऑन अर्थ, राइट? सम ऑफ दीज सेल्स इवॉल्व्ड to give out oxygen. So I have already told you many times that who are the pioneers of oxygenic photosynthesis, beta? Do you all remember this word? Who are the pioneers? Means who were the first one to give out oxygen by the process of photosynthesis, that is PS1, PS2, dono mein present hai, aise kaun se organisms the? Who is this? Parnavi, very nice. You're perfectly right. Very good, Snehasi. Excellent. Come on, others, please, please. I've got two correct answers. I mean, the same correct answer from Parnavi also and Sneha also. Very good, David Jain. Excellent, beta. Excellent, excellent. Others, please, you have to answer this because this is one of the most favorite questions of the examiners. Who are the pioneers of oxygenic photosynthesis? All three of you have given me the correct answer. All three. Come on, others. Give a try. An important question. No, not aerobic bacteria. The answer is not only aerobic bacteria. There is specification to it. Try it out. Who is this? Preksha. Very good. Yes, Ishita. Very nice. Very nice. So, Some of you are giving me the right answer and you're putting a question mark against it, but it's the right answer. Don't worry, your answer is perfectly right. Yes, Viva. Eukaryotes? No, it's not eukaryotic organisms. They are prokaryotes only. Viva, you are also correct, beta. Arya, you're right. Arya, perfect. Right answer, Arya. Very good, Manan. So it's going to be your cyanobacteria or your blue green algae, as we say, which is going to be the first one who has, had PS1 and PS2, right? So they were the first one to give out oxygen during photosynthesis. That is by splitting of water, right? So as we say, photolysis of water, that photolysis of water is due to the presence of both the systems. Photosystems, that is PS1, PS2, right? Well, so that was the ones we are talking about, that some of these cells evolved to give out oxygen, right? Slowly, multicellular forms evolved, right? By the time 500 million years ago, invertebrates were formed and were active. Okay, invertebrates, we have already studied animal kingdom, right? In that animal kingdom, you know who are invertebrates, right? You know who is vertebrates. You know about animal kingdom. So I did not again go into the details of these. But when was the birth of the invertebrates? They are saying 500 million years ago. Okay. Jawless fish evolved probably 350 million years ago. Can you all tell me something about jawless fish? Any example of jawless fish? You know that there is something called as Egnatha, Nathostomata, Cyclostomata. So, mujhe batao beta, jawless fish, for example. Animal kingdom again. Okay, Ashwin. Okay, fine. But there are few examples given in your NCRT for these jawless fish. Okay, fine. Yes, Priksha. Correct answer. Okay, fine. Yes, you are right. Others, give a try, beta. Jawless fish. Very good. Yes. Actually, lamprey and hagfish are given in your books, right? Yes. So these are going to be your jawless. What are they called as? What is that group of organism, jawless fish walo ko kya naam diya gaya hai? Correct. Hai na? So, ye jo Egnatha ko belong karne wale hote hai humare jawless fish, inka janam kab hua? Is what it is predicted by the geologists. It is around 350 million years ago is what they are saying. Okay? Now look at the, form or the pattern of evolution, how they are talking about that. So, these are the questions that they ask you. 500 million years ago, who developed? 350 million years ago, who were evolved? And so on. So you should know these things. Then see, first to invade land were the plants. That means first life on land again was going to be of the plants. They were widespread on the land when animals invaded land. Okay, so by the time the animals could invade land, by the time animals could develop or adapt to the land or terrestrial lifestyle, plants had already completely established themselves on land. Fine. Now see, around 350 million years ago, fish with stout and strong fins could move on land and go back to water. See, they're talking about the world called as fish. And they're saying fish could come on land and go back to water. Don't you think these should be amphibians actually? Yeah, look at this. Look at this. This is your coelacanth. Ye wala. Aayega abhi. In 1938, a fish caught in South Africa happened to be a coelacanth, which was thought to be extinct. So this is going to be your coelacanth. Ye jo hai na ye dekho. This one. Okay. So these animals called as lobe fins. Ye dekho, these fins are called as what? Lobe fins, and therefore these animals only were called as lobe fins. Evolved as first amphibians. So those fish, they were earlier called as fish. These were also around 350 million years ago, who had a snout and strong fins. Look at this. Look at this mouth part. Don't you think it's snout? Hai na? So ye snout ke jaisa nikal aaya hai, aur unko hai na bahut strong fins hai. Aisa wala jo fish 350 million years ago develop hua tha, eventually they evolved as first amphibian. Okay, got it. Now see, these are the ancestors of modern day frogs and salamanders. So who are the ancestors of modern day frog and salamanders? The lobe fish. Okay, I've given the diagram, this photograph of the lobe fish. It belongs to coelacanth, and it was, you know, like caught in the net of the fishermen in South Africa in the year 1938. Okay, yeah, they'll come. So this is how your amphibians have evolved. For this, so key points iske note kar lena beta. Aage aur bhi hai, geological scale aur bhi hame padhna hai, but still on this particular slide. Any difficulty with this? How did you know the evolution begin and how it progressed? Simple. Now see here. The amphibians eventually evolved into reptiles. Okay. Amphibians eventually evolved into reptiles. Correct. Now, they lack shelled eggs which do not dry up in the sun, unlike those of the amphibians. Okay. So who lacks shelled eggs? Who lacks the reptiles? Okay. So the reptiles lack thick shelled eggs which do not dry up in the sun, unlike those of the amphibians. Their modern day descendants are turtles, tortoises, and crocodiles. Okay. So see how the evolution has occurred. Bahut dheere dheere dheere. It has not occurred all of a sudden. It's a very slow and steady process. Okay. In the next 200 million years ago, reptiles of different shapes and sizes dominated on the earth. Some of these land reptiles went back into water to evolve into fish-like reptiles, which is going to be your ichthyosaurus. Can you see? You know who is ichthyosaurus? Who is this ichthyosaurus? Naam se pata chalega. Saurus. The saurus, as we say. Who is it? Ichthyosaurus, come on. It will be which type of an animal or a reptile? It belongs to whom? Yes, exactly. A dinosaur. So dinosaur ka ek type tha, ichthyosaur. And it had the, it had adapted to live on land also, and it could go to water also. You see, some of these land reptiles went back to water to evolve into fish-like reptiles. So one of the example was your ichthyosaurus. Don't forget the name, it's important. The land reptiles that time were dinosaurs. The biggest of them, Tyrannosaurus rex, was about 20 feet in height and had a huge, fearsome, dagger-like teeth. Look at this. This is the photograph of Tyrannosaurus. Tyrannosaurus rex, 20 feet in height. 20 feet. ओके हमारे में जो टॉल बंदे होते हैं वो जनरली 6 फीट एवरेज होते हैं. सो 20 मींस 3 टाइम्स ऑफ देम ऑलमोस्ट, राइट? सो ह्यूज. एंड लुक एट देयर टीथ, दे रियली हैड अ फियरसम टीथ, डैगर लाइक टीथ. अबाउट 65 मिलियन इयर्स अगो द डायनासोर सडनली डिसअपीयर्ड फ्रॉम द अर्थ. सो 200 मिलियन इयर्स अगो दे इवॉल्वड एज डायनासोर. ओके. And after 65 million years ago, okay, they got suddenly disappeared. So they were you know, on Earth for how many years, how many million years did they inhabit the Earth? Can you all tell me? Exactly. Very good, Sneha. Very good. Yeah, it's 135 million years. They were predominantly existing on Earth. 135 million years. It's not a small span. It's a huge span, right? And all of a sudden, they became extinct. Okay. But what happens is they evolved eventually is what is being argued, that they shrunk in size and they evolved to get adapted to, you know, escape from adverse environmental conditions, and they reduced their size so that they could go and hide themselves under the rocks, in the crevices of the walls, and you know, like they could hide. The main reason for their evolution was, you know, to escape from the adverse environmental conditions. Okay, so yes, exactly. So Namita, eventually they say that small size reptiles of that era still exist today. So it has been argued that these lizards and all, na, see, even they appeared so yuck to us, na. Kaise dikhte hai wo lizard? Kuch aise hi ajeeb gareeb type ke reduced form lagte hai mujhe to. Aise hi hote hai wo ekdam gande se. The eyes popping up, propelling, looking at you in every, you know, from every point of angle.
तू बात करे मत.
ओए ओए ओए, someone's mic is on. Arya, your mic is on. Yeah, you know, like maybe that argument, whatever is put forward, maybe true also. We don't know. So what we have to remember on this particular slide, you understood the key points. It's easy. It's, as I told you, an evolution is a story. It's more like a fun, you know. It's not like conceptually kuch bahut bada difficult hai. No issues, beta, no issues. So it's a story, you know, like how it goes about. Hai na? Yeah. It could be. It seems to be. Yes, Manan, you're right, beta. Yeah. So see, when the reptiles disappeared, means these large reptiles, okay, those dinosaurs, as they disappeared, mammals started dominating the Earth. They are saying dominating. That means mammals were already present earlier. They are not saying mammals started, you know, were found out for the first time. No. Dominating. Yes, you are right. You are right, Prachi. Very true. Okay. The first mammal was like shrew. This is shrew, beta. Ye dekho. Ye hai na, ye shrew hai. ये जो फोटो मैंने डाला है ये श्रीव का फोटो है बेटा. जो छोटे छोटे एनिमल्स होते हैं ना, बहुत छोटे, ये देखे आपने? श्रीव्स आर फाउंड, यू कैन सी श्रीव्स समटाइम्स, नॉट वेरी ऑफन. दे अपीयर लाइक रैट्स ओनली, बट दे आर वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज, एंड लुक एट दे आर पॉइंटेड स्नाउट. ये श्रूज है, श्रूज. So the first mammal was like a shrew. There were mammals like horse, hippopotamus, rabbit, bear, etc. in South America. But due to continental drift, have you all heard about that word continental drift? How the seven continents drifted away, they tore apart. You know that story? Suna hai kabhi aapne? हाँ, तो वो जब ऐसे फट गए थे ना सारे एक दूसरे से, और बीच में देन देयर वाज वाटर दैट वाज सेपरेटिंग द टू कॉन्टिनेंट्स इवेंचुअली, राइट? सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट, नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, पाउच्ड मैमल्स ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया सर्वाइव बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन फ्रॉम एनी अदर मैमल. सो देयर वाज कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट, ड्यू टू दिस कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट द कॉन्टिनेंट सेपरेटेड, राइट? बट there were many mammals who got killed due to the internal competition, but pouched mammals who drifted along with that continent to Australia, there no other mammal generally drifted. So you know, all those pouched mammals, we know pouched mammals are called as marsupials now, but still, so these pouched mammals, they got segregated segregated, separated, and there was no competition between any one of them. So they could survive and sustain. Even today, Australia is famous for kangaroos, right? So that is how they said that due to lack of competition, there were certain mammals which became predominantly, sustaining in that particular area. Correct? Now, some mammals like whales, dolphins, seals, sea cows, they started living under the water completely. So they wholly live in water. Okay? Now, na beta, here, this particular diagram which I have put up over here, in the previous syllabus, not your syllabus, my dear. Yeah, Shruti, you're right, beta. Forming mountains, plateaus, and all that drift, continental drift resulted into all these. So here now you can see this is the evolution of horse. Now, this is not there in your current syllabus, but in the previous year's question papers, questions have been asked on evolution of horse because it was a part of their syllabus. But what has happened now, just for the sake of asking something very unknown to the students, sometimes such type of questions are asked in your examination. So what we should know, no need of going into too much depth of the history or the evolution of horse in detail, but at least understand that what are the key points about it. Okay, so here you can see Eohippus. This was the first horse-like organism or the most primitive form of horse that was found. It was 50 million years ago. Okay, now look at these 1, 2, 3, 4. Can you see? 1, 2, 3, 4. These are going to be the toes. And look at this. You can see this one, which is going to be the largest white colored one. Right? So this is called as a tassel. So 3 toes, 1 tassel. Here you can see Mesohippus. It evolved from Eohippus around 35 million years ago. And there are only 1, 2. The third one is lost. But this tassel is still existing. Merihippus. 10 million years ago, look at the reduced toes and look at this tassel that remains as it is. Okay, then this is Pleohippus. It was 5 million years ago. Now you can see the toes have almost, the side toes have almost gone, only you can't see them. But this has developed very nice. This tassel has developed very nice. Correct? And look at this Equus. Equus is the one which is present at present. The horse that we find is called as your Equus. E-Q-U-I-S. E-Q-U-U-S. Equus. So this Equus is the present day horse. Here you can see this tassel has become more stronger and more adapted. So look at the feet. Beta, ye dekho. Iska feet dekho. Ye dekho. Ye finger like hai na. Iske wajah se. फिर ये जो है ये पीछे की तरफ दिख रहा है तुम्हें, ये वाला इधर पीछे एक छोटा सा एक्सटेंशन है, ये वाला. ओके, अब ये जो एक्सटेंशन है ना वो ऑलमोस्ट चला गया है और इसके जो टैसल्स है या जो जो फूट होता है उसका, वो कैसा दिख रहा है देखो, छोटा है. एंड नाउ लुक एट दिस वन, दिस इज रियली स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड स्टर्डी, राइट? दिस इज योर, सो दिस इज योर हॉर्स एवोल्यूशन. दिस इज जस्ट फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन. If at all any question comes, you should know at least something about it. So I've put the horse's evolutionary history over here. Okay. Well, then the next one is the geologists, how they have studied this entire geological pattern. Let us understand that. The geologists have divided the geological time into intervals, which are characterized by significant events that occurred in the organization of organisms. So, they have divided the events into certain groups based on eras, periods, and epochs. So, what are eras, what are periods, and what are epochs is something we have to understand. See, the major division of geological time are eras. Major division. The eras are further divided into periods, and the periods are further divided into epochs. So I show you the chart, you will come to know. These are arranged on the time scale in order of their age, and this arrangement is called as geological time scale. By studying fossils in the earth's crust, the evolutionary changes. Now see, yeah, we are talking about the paleontological study. The evolutionary changes in the organisms have been traced out. Okay, so what is this? We'll come to know only when we see this chart. See, so the major time scale is going to be eras. Eras are further, so this is one era, second era, third era, fourth era, like that way. So ye eras hai. Eras has further divided into what? Periods. See, so for example, if you see Paleozoic era, it is divided into how many periods? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 periods, right? And these 6 periods are further divided into epochs. So if you see tertiary period, it is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 epochs. Okay, got it? And here they are giving the events what have occurred, what changes have occurred for the scientists to divide them into these small divisions and subdivisions. Fine. So let us see this in detail now. A very important and the most important topic for your examination. Yeah, my dear, these have to be remembered. You have to remember these, my dear. Okay. So instead of coming from top to the bottom, you're going to go from bottom to the top because it's 4,600 million years ago to 65.5 million years ago. So the most primitive to the most recent, we always go like that way. This whole table, no, not necessary this whole table. I'll tell you how to go about it. Okay, don't worry. See this. So this is called as Precambrian era. What is the name? Precambrian era. It was 4,600 million years ago to 570 million years ago. So during this particular time, what all events occurred? What are the predominant events that have occurred? Okay. Now, this is further divided into Herion, Eon, Herion, Echidion, and Proto-Tetrazoic era, Eon. Okay. So no need of remembering these four names as of now. Not required. See, I am telling you, you note down these things. Then you will get confused. What is required to be remembered and what is not required to be remembered is important. Okay. So Precambrian, ye word aapko yaad rakhna hai. Iske periods nahi yaad rakhoge to bhi chalega. Fine. Iska epoch ya age nahi yaad rakhoge to bhi chalega. Theek hai? Okay. So of course, the period's name is Pleistocene period. It was from 4,600 million years ago. So what happened over there? See, atmosphere and ocean were formed and oldest rocks were formed as the earth cooled. So the very beginning that we saw in this chapter, that the earth started cooling, then there was condensation that took place that led to the formation of oceans and seas. This particular event has occurred 4,600 million years ago. ठीक है? फिर दूसरा इवेंट क्या हुआ देखो बेटा? So around 2,500 to 3,800 million years ago क्या हुआ था? Photosynthesizing cyanobacteria appeared and first unicellular life form was seen on the earth. Okay. So, ये जो events है ना बेटा, these events are the same events. These events are the same events which are, occurred, which have occurred earlier, and we have already read about it, right? But now we are just grouping them. Okay. So, cyanobacteria का जन्म देखो कब हुआ है? Around 2,500 million years ago to around 3,800 million years ago, cyanobacteria evolved. Right, and even today we have got cyanobacteria, my dears. Even today we see Nostoc, Oscillatoria. We see them even today. देखो कितने primitive है ना ये. इसीलिए तो वो किस में आते हैं बेटा? Monera, right? Yeah. then you can see first soft-bodied animals appeared. Can you all tell me who are the soft-bodied animals according to our animal kingdom? Who will tell me what are soft-bodied animals? No, I know many of you all will say mollusk. So who is this? Sneha. Only you have answered it correctly. What is it? Yes, Parnavi, you're right. It's going to be your sponges. Porifera. Sponges. Okay. They were going to be, you know, the most primitive and the simplest form of animalia, right? Porifera is the simplest form of animalia. So they evolved. So they are considered as a soft-bodied one. Okay. Then first multicellular life appeared. So from unicellular life, now multicellular life has appeared around 570 to 2500 million years ago. Okay. So one, two, three. Three events have occurred during the Precambrian era. Is it okay? Have you all understood what has happened during the Precambrian era? Anyone who is having any difficulty? So what are the things that you have to remember? The name Precambrian era and from which to which million years ago it was existing and which events have occurred in this particular era. They are soft-bodied, my dear mollusks, but they have got a hard calcareous external or internal shell, as you know about in sepia, it would have internal one, right? And others would be external, correct? So because of that, they do not come under pure soft body mollusk. Okay, yes. Then we come to the Paleozoic era. Now this Paleozoic era mein bahut zyada events hue hai beta, aur ye Paleozoic era maximum evolution mein contribution karta hai. So let us see which are those. One is the Cambrian. So ye pre-Cambrian hai, abhi aage hum Cambrian pe. But Cambrian is not an era. Cambrian is a period. Mind you all. Isiliye idhar hamesha bachche gadbad karenge. The name of the era is Paleozoic era. And the period that is going to be in that Paleozoic era will be Cambrian. Got it? Understood? So just like the year 2021, if we consider it to be the era, then the month June would be the period. And the date, what is it? 3rd June today, right? Would be your epoch. For example, bata rahi hu isko kaise divide kiya hai. So 2021 ke June ke 3rd ko kya hua? So 10 baje evolution chapter start hua. Ye event hua hai. Hai na? So 10 baje became your million years ago wala part. How to classify? Wo samjhane ke liye bata rahi. So era is divided into periods. So the Cambrian is going to be the period, while the Precambrian is going to be your era. Is it fine? I hope no difficulty. Yeah. Now what happened in this Cambrian period? But if you see Cambrian, Orodocetian is going to be together called as age of invertebrates. So now this is the age of invertebrates, my dears. So what happens, see, it is the end of Bottomian extinction event. Bottomian extinction event means these anaerobic organisms, especially those who could not withstand oxygenic conditions, they got killed. Then first fungi appeared. So even fungus is, see, 570 million years ago, se lekar ye fungus hamare saath hai. So the first fungi appeared. And trilobites became dominant. So trilobites are going to be your invertebrates specifically, which became predominant. Okay. Then if you see here in Ordovician era, Ordovician period, what happened? Silurian extinction event. So the first vertebrates appeared. Means what happened? Ye Ordovician mein, ye Ordovician mein. Silurian का extinction होके, sorry, Ordovician का extinction होके, Silurian event start हो गया. So you can see this Silurian period. First land plants appeared. first jawfish appeared, first insects appeared. So insects are also around 245 to 570 million years ago. Okay. Yeah, so that was around 570 million years ago when insects have appeared, first land plants have appeared, and first jawfish have appeared. Okay, that is going to be your Silurian period. Look at the Devonian period, age of fish. Devonians is going to be called as age of fish. Late Devonian extinction event, first land animals appeared, first amphibians appeared. Okay, so what will be the way we need it? The first amphibians appeared, first land animals appeared, and late Devonian extinction event occurred during the Devonian period. Carboniferous, naam se pata chal raha hai, something associated with the carbon. Yes, so first large cartilaginous fish appeared. Can you all tell me the example of cartilaginous fish? Large cartilaginous fish. Who? Come on. Tell me the answer. Exactly. Yes. Come on, others. Cartilaginous fish. Bony fish, cartilaginous fish. You have heard about chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. I'm talking about chondrichthyes. Someone was asking me about shark and all. I said, it will come eventually. Here it is. Very good. All of you are correct, beta. So here what has happened, in the Carboniferous era, period, this Carboniferous period and Paleozoic era, it's going to be the cartilaginous fish also going to appear, and reptiles, first reptiles occurred. Okay. And look at this. Permian period is called as age of amphibians. So here we are saying the Pangaea forms appeared and Permian and Triassic extinction event. So, this begin actually. So Permian period is going to be specifically associated with amphibians. So if you look at the Paleozoic era, what are the important points? Age of invertebrates, age of fish, age of amphibians. Almost all important, a line of evolution has occurred during this Paleozoic era. Don't you think so? Hena, invertebrates bhi develop hue, fish bhi develop hue, aur amphibians bhi develop hue. Aur idhar to actually reptiles ke baare mein bhi unhone bola hai ki first reptile occurred. Though it is not called as age of reptiles. Okay? Got it? So, very important period. You have to remember these name of the periods. For Paleozoic era, you have to remember the name of the period. You have to remember the name of the epoch. And you have to remember what has happened during this. So, ye jo Paleozoic era ke baare mein, jo bhi ek ye pura rectangle hai na, ye pura aapko yaad karna hai. There is no option to leave anything about the Paleozoic era. As I told you, Precambrian ka, aapko ye bhi nahi, koi bhi yaad nahi rakhna hai. Just remember the name Precambrian. And just remember what are the events that occurred. But for Paleozoic, everything has to be remembered. Very precise. Is it fine? Okay. Then we come to Mesozoic era. Can you see this? Mesozoic era, which is called as age of reptiles. Age of reptiles. Which was 245 million years ago to 65.5 million years ago. The first period is Triassic period, which first dinosaurs occurred during that particular period. So you can see reptiles became dominant. First mammals appeared and Pangaea cracks. Okay. So Pangaea cracks means the Pangaea which was formed over here, it became extinct now. Fine. So these Pangaea are not there only, they have become extinct. So there is no literature on Pangaea. Okay. Now, first mammals appeared during which period is what they ask you very frequently, beta. So, first mammals, Mesozoic era, and which period? Triassic period. Is it fine? So, this is a common question that they ask you, and you should know these names. लुक एट जुरासिक, जुरासिक तो आपको पता ही है, जुरासिक इज नथिंग बट द जुरासिक पार्क वाला मूवीज हैज ऑलरेडी मेड द डायनासोर्स वेरी फेमस, राइट? सो यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट दिस जुरासिक पीरियड, राइट? सो जुरासिक पीरियड बिलोंग टू मीजोजोइक एरा एंड ऑफ कोर्स डायनासोर्स आर डोमिनेंट ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम. पांजिया स्प्लिट्स इनटू लॉरेजिया एंड गोंडवाना. तो लॉरेजिया एंड गोंडवाना आल्सो यू नो इवेंचुअली दे वर रेप्टाइल्स ओनली, दे वर रेप्टाइल्स, स्मॉलर रेप्टाइल्स. ओके, सो वी सॉ जस्ट नाउ दैट द लार्जर रेप्टाइल्स देन यू नो बिकेम एक्सटिंक्ट एंड दे गिव राइज टू स्मॉलर रेप्टाइल्स. सो दिस लॉरेजिया एंड गोंडवाना आर स्मॉलर रेप्टाइल्स, फाइन. एंड हियर यू कैन सी फर्स्ट बर्ड्स अपीयर्ड. So birds for the first time appeared during the Jurassic period of the Mesozoic era. Mammals first appeared during the Triassic period of Mesozoic era. देखो कितने questions frame होते हैं सिर्फ इसके ऊपर, हाँ. Try to analyze that. Now the first birds have appeared in the Jurassic period of Mesozoic era. Then came your Cretaceous period. Cretaceous period was called as extinction of dinosaurs. Okay, so it is around 65 million years ago that we saw, right? See, now flowering plants appeared for the first time. So plants appeared for the first time in which particular is this thing, beta? Where did you see that first land plants appeared? See here, Silurian period. देखो यहाँ पर Phylozoic era का first land plants appeared. This was how many years ago? Around say 438 million years ago, first plants appeared. And when did the flowering plants appear? See, 145 million years ago. Means it took approximately more than 300 million years for the flowering plants to develop. Agreed? Correct? Dinosaurs ate everything, whatever was there. They were not predominantly vegetarians. They ate whatever was found during that particular, that Pangaeas that I have told. They became extinct actually because of overconsumption by these dinosaurs only. Well, so here you can see the first flowering plants have appeared. Correct? Now, Earth looks closer to present day. So, what do you mean by Earth looks closer to the present day? So now, what Earth appears to us today, somewhat similar type of conditions were there during this period in the Cretaceous period, okay? So now from that period to this particular period, which we are experiencing is a quaternary period of your Cenozoic era, there is no much difference in the Earth's topographical, structures, I would say. Okay. KT extinction event, that is your dinosaurs became completely extinct and mammals were now going to become more predominant on the land. Okay. So that is extinction of dinosaurs in Cretaceous period of the Mesozoic era. First dinosaur appeared also in the Mesozoic era, and extinction of dinosaurs also took place in the Mesozoic era. But that was your Triassic period. This is your Cretaceous period. And if you look at the time span, it is 245 million years ago, and this is 65.5 million years ago. Okay. Then came your Cenozoic era, which is even today currently followed. Even today, we have got the Cenozoic era only, which is called as Age of Mammals. It is 65.5 million years ago and till present day, till today. Kaun sa era chal raha hai beta? Cenozoic era chal raha hai. Ab isme do phases hai ya do periods hai, tertiary and quaternary. So tertiary period mein kya kya hua hai dekho? We have got Paleocene epoch. First large mammals appeared. Eocene epoch. That is Oligocene extinction event. Oligocene extinction event means what? Whatever is going to be, going to be in the Oligocene, इसका ईओसीन का भी जो बीच का है, ईओसीन एंड ऑलिगोसीन के बीच का जो टाइम पीरियड है वो एक्सटिंक्ट हो गया, लीडिंग टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ऑलिगोसीन. सो ऑलिगोसीन में मैमल्स आर डोमिनेंट, इवन टुडे मैमल्स आर डोमिनेंट. मियोसीन ग्रास बिकेम वाइड स्प्रेड, मियोसीन ग्रासेस, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ ग्रासेस बिकेम वाइड स्प्रेड ड्यूरिंग मियोसीन. प्लायोसीन होमिनिड्स, ह्यूमन लाइक ऑर्गेनिजम्स, सो होमिनिड्स अपियर्ड, ह्यूमन एंसेस्टर्स अपियर्ड. सो हमारा जो एंसेस्ट्री है इट बिगिंस फॉर जस्ट 5.3 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो एज कंपेयर टू ऑल दीज. सो वी the humans developed from which particular epoch? Pliocene epoch of quaternary period of Cenozoic era. So again, this is a very common question. What is the speciality of Pliocene? Pliocene epoch has seen the formation or evolution of hominids, that is human-like organisms, or the primitive or the ancestors of humans. Okay. Pleistocene, earliest ice age begins and earliest human appear. Ice age. You have seen that movie of Ice Age? There was a movie based on Ice Age. There was some English movie, I guess. Have you all seen? Yeah, in that, they have shown it very beautifully. Very beautifully, they have shown about the Ice Age. So the Ice Age begins and earliest humans have now started to appear. How many million years ago, my dear? See, 0.01 to 1.6 million years ago. Very recent, right? Right? Yeah, yeah, it's in 4-5. Yes, beta. And at present, what is going on is our Holocene epoch. Humans are dominant and of course, Ice Age has ended, right? So this is going to be your Holocene. Current situation, we all are into Holocene epoch of the quaternary period of Cenozoic era. Okay, so here also you have to remember the epochs and the events. Tertiary quaternary to jyada tension hai nahi, quaternary do mi hai, Holocene and Pleistocene. So isme to aapko yaad rahega, but these names have to be remembered. Okay, that is Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene, and Pliocene. Okay, Paleo, Plio, Pleisto. इसमें बहुत गड़बड़ होता है. Paleological study, paleontological study means your fossil study. इधर से मिलते हैं हमें generally maximum mammals के जो एक्सटिंक्ट मैमल्स के जो फॉसिल्स मिलते हैं ना वो जनरली ये वाले इसमें मिलते हैं, पेलोसीन एरा वाले. गॉड नोज व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एवोल्यूशन विल अकर आफ्टर होलोसीन, वी रियली डोंट नो. प्रोबेबली यू नो नाउ दिस होलोसीन एरा इज कमिंग टू एन एंड. नहीं लग रहा है तुम्हें ऐसे? लुक एट द नंबर ऑफ डेथ्स अकरिंग एवरी डे ड्यू टू दिस कोविड. Yeah, maybe there would be some, yes, Vedika, right, but maybe there will be something that, yeah, robotic era may come, very nice, okay. There's going to be some event that is now, that is the word, that is the thing that I'm saying, that majority of humans are, you know, udhar upar recruitment pura chal raha hai, bahut zyada vacancies upar ho gayi hai, hai na? इतनी वैकेंसी हो गई, इतनी वैकेंसीज हो गई है, फुल ऑन रिक्रूटमेंट. किसका नंबर कब लगेगा पता नहीं है, ऐसा सिचुएशन है आजकल. करेक्ट, एज नो बार, रिक्रूटमेंट फुल ऑन, कम ऑन. हाँ, सीवी अप्लाई भी नहीं करना पड़ता है आपको, रेज्यूमे अपलोड नहीं करना पड़ता है, वो ऊपर वाला सिलेक्ट कर लेता है परफेक्ट कैंडिडेट, कम ऑन. राइट, सो वी रियली डोंट नो दैट व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन द नेक्स्ट few years also, which particular epoch will start, will the Cenozoic era remain or bhi kuch naya era aa jayega, we really don't know, hai na? We have to wait and we have to see, right? Okay, so this is a very important point, chart of your geological time scale. My dears, this geological time scale chart is not going to be found in your NCERT perfectly, but it's given very well in your government textbook. Hai na? Maybe the name could be any better. Yeah, so this is what is geological time scale ka division. Any doubts, any confusion in this particular chart, beta, with anyone? Anyone who would like not understand anything and would like to ask me anything on this? Yes. So now we come to the literature of this chart to some extent. Many things would be like repeated wale parts. Just see, some of the single-celled organisms that appeared 2000 MYA had pigments to capture solar energy and release oxygen in the process of photosynthesis. Eventually, bryophytes were the first plants to colonize the land. So the first life forms which were capable of invading the land and colonize it were the bryophytes. Seaweeds, seaweeds and few plants existed around 320 million years ago. What are seaweeds? What are seaweeds, my dear? You remember this word, seaweeds? Very good. Very good, Ishita. Excellent. Yes. Yes. Perfect answer. Seaweeds are nothing but your brown algae. Just now we completed plant kingdom. Huh? So your brown algae are going to be called as your seaweeds. Okay. So the seaweeds and few plants existed from 320 MYA. About 200 million years ago, giant ferns, ferns are pteridophytes, were present, but they all fell to form coal deposits slowly. So do you remember, like we had talked about, coal mines and the fossils that were, found in the strata of the stones especially. Look over here. Look at this. These are your stones. See? These are your stones. And there are, molds. I had talked about molds and casts when I had talked about paleontological study. So these are the molds that have been formed on the rocks of the ferns. Right? Herbaceous lycopods and arborescent lycopods evolved from zoosterophyllum of Phelozoic era. Just now we saw Phelozoic era mein maximum cheeze hui hai. So herbaceous lycopods. Do you remember lycopod is going to be the class belonging to which particular group of organism? Lycopod or Lycopsida, as we say. Lycopsida belongs to whom? Very good. Yes, Neha Singh, you're right. Come on, Lycopsida, Sphenopsida, Psilopsida. I told you all these. No, not angiosperms. Angiosperms is only monocotyledonia and dicotyledonia. Where is this? Lycopsida. I told you have to remember the examples that have been given for Lycopsida, Sphenopsida. Come on. Ah, yes. But we are right now. Come on. Others try to answer this quickly. I'd also given the examples of each one of them. Beta, plant kingdom nahi padoge na, to bahut ganak se हार जाओगे यार तुम लोग. एग्जामिनेशन पहले ही बता रही हूँ. बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर है मॉर्फोलॉजी, प्लांट किंगडम, बॉटनी के ये दो तीन चैप्टर्स बहुत ज्यादा, ट्रांसपोर्ट इन प्लांट्स, ये बहुत ही ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर्स है. यू कैन नॉट निग्लेक्ट देम एट ऑल. सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर्स है ये बॉटनी वाले. व्हेन आई हैड टॉट यू दिस, आई हैड टोल्ड यू ऑल That match the following में ये आता है. एक साइड पे ये सारे देंगे नाम और दूसरे साइड पे देंगे उसके एग्जाम्पल्स. एंड यू आर ऑट टू रिमेम्बर दिस. Psilopsida, Lycopsida, Spinopsida, Pteridopsida. हाँ, ये नहीं बताया था मैंने. Pteridopsida में दो एग्जाम्पल्स थे, Spinopsida में एक ही एग्जाम्पल था, Psilopsida में सिलोटम था एग्जाम्पल. सो आई टोल्ड यू दैट सिलोटम एंड Psilopsida इजी है रिमेम्बर करने के लिए. Then I told you about Equisetum. Do you remember? They all belong to your Pteridopsida. So herbaceous lycopods are going to be your Pteridopsida ke group mein ko belong karne wale plants. And arborescent lycopods means what? What do you mean by the word arborescent? Arboreal adaptation kya hota hai? What is arborescent? Those who are going to be found hanging on trees. So both of them have evolved from Zoosterophyllum of the Paleozoic era. Come on, you have to be very, very, very alert with the things that have already, taught to you all. This is not the way. Coelophyton or Psilopsida as we say, or Psilotum as we call it now, is the common ancestor of horsetails, ferns, and gymnosperms. Okay? So horsetails, ferns, and gymnosperms all have evolved from Coelophyton, is what the ancestral study says. Okay? Be careful, be careful. Look at this. This is a diagram given in your NCERT textbook, which will not be understood by anyone, which will not be taught also by anyone, I bet you. Because there are so many, people who themselves are not aware ki isko kaise samjhaya jaye, ye kya hai, yehi samajh mein nahi aata. Main samjha rahi hu beta, dhyan de do isko. Aur ye diagram based questions iske upar bahut aate hain. So please pay attention to whatever I'm saying now. This is a sketch of the evolution of plant forms through the ecological time periods. The very first one to develop were the chlorophyte ancestors. What do you mean by chlorophyte? Chlorophyte, see, come on. What is chlorophyte? Quickly, why so much of time? What are chlorophytes? Arey. अरे प्लांट्स विद क्लोरोफिल, क्या क्लोरोफाइसी हैव टॉट यू? इट्स अ क्लास ऑफ एल्गे. क्लोरोफाइसी है, फियोफाइसी है, रोडोफाइसी है, हैवंट आई टॉट यू दैट? हाँ, तो क्लोरोफाइट पूछ रही हूँ, क्लोरोफाइसी है पूछ रही हूँ. क्लोरोफाइड एंसेस्टर्स बेसिकली द क्लोरोफाइसी है और द फोटोसिंथेटिक पिगमेंट ग्रीन कलर वाले जो है, दोज वर दी मोस्ट प्रिमिटिव एंसेस्टर्स हु फ्रॉम हुम द एंटायर प्लांट वर्ल्ड हैज इवॉल्व्ड. ओके, फ्रॉम दिस क्लोरोफाइट ये डेवलप ट्रेकियोफाइट. डू यू ऑल रिमेम्बर द वर्ड ट्रेकियोफाइट? आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हाट इज ट्रेकियो. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ट्रेकियोफाइट? आई टोल्ड यू टेरिडोफाइट, जिम्नोस्पर्म्स एंड एंजियोस्पर्म्स आर ट्रेकियोफाइट. वेरी गुड हिमांशु, excellent. Others, what do you mean by the word tracheophyte? Not tracheids. Yes, Samiksha, you're right. Samiksha and Himanshu have given me the right answer till now. Come on, others try. Very good, Ishita. Yes, Vibha, very nice, very good. So basically tracheophytes are those which are going to be called as vascular plants, right? So in algae and bryophytes, they were not having any vascular systems, but from pteridophyta onwards, vascular system developed, correct? So tracheophytes developed. So from algae, they are saying tracheophytes have evolved. From tracheophytes, they are saying rhina type plants have developed. What are these rhina type plants? Rhina type plants are going to be an intermediate step wherein the tracheids, the vessels are not very well demarked, but yes, they are going to be present. Yes, xylem and phloem. Correct. Okay. So, tracheophytes and Brinia-like plants ke beech mein se ye thin line nikal rahi hai. Can you see? Dekho ye wala. Hai na? So, tracheophytes and Brinia, matlab tracheophytes ke characteristics in mein hai. Tracheophytes ke characteristics in mein hai. ऐसा एक ब्रांच यहाँ से निकल रहा है ड्यूरिंग द सिल्यूरियन पीरियड व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज ज़ूस्टेरोफाइलम. कैन यू सी ज़ूस्टेरोफाइलम? है ना? फ्रॉम ज़ूस्टेरोफाइलम आर्बोरेसेंट लाइकोपॉड्स एंड हर्बेशियस लाइकोपॉड्स हैव डेवलप्ड. कैन यू सी दिस? राइट. एंड इफ यू सी दिस ब्रायोफाइट्स का डेवलपमेंट, लुक वेयर इट इज गोइंग बिटवीन क्लोरोफाइसिए एंड ट्रेक्योफाइट. तो ये ब्रायोफाइट है हमारे. इसलिए जब हम प्लांट किंगडम पढ़े तो हम कैसे पढ़े? हैलोफाइट्स, ब्रायोफाइट्स, टेरिडोफाइट. करेक्ट. सो ब्रायोफाइट वॉज सैंडविच्ड बिटवीन एंड वी सॉ इन ब्रायोफाइट्स दे हैव गॉट रूट लाइक स्टेम लाइक लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स. करेक्ट. दे डिड नॉट हैव समथिंग कॉल्ड एज रूट स्टेम लीफ लाइक द ट्रेक्योफाइट. Because before they could evolve to form root, stem, leaf, xylem, phloem, etc., उसके पहले ही evolution हुआ है. What is it going to be called as, beta? It is going to be called as your, it is going to be called as your bryophyta का evolution. Could you see this? So this in Carboniferous time period of the Paleozoic era, Carboniferous हमने नाम पढ़ा था अभी अभी बराबर है. उस time पे ये ब्रायोफाइट्स बनने को स्टार्ट हुए हैं, व्हिच वी जस्ट नाउ रेड, राइट? दे एग्जिस्टेड एंड दे सस्टेन्ड. लुक एट द शेप ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर कोन, इट इज यूनिफॉर्म. ओके. सो दे इवॉल्व्ड इन स्मॉल नंबर्स एंड देन दे हैव मेंटेन्ड देयर स्पीशीज. दे हैव नॉट इंक्रीज, दे हैव नॉट डिक्रीज, दे हैव मेंटेन्ड इट. सी, लुक एट द, लुक एट दिस पर्टिकुलर यू नो कॉलम. राइट है? समझ में आया? सो दे सस्टेन्ड, दे फ्लरिश्ड फ्रॉम द कार्बोनिफेरस पीरियड, परमियन, ट्रायासिक, जुरासिक, क्रिटेनियस एंड इवन टुडे इन आवर करंट सीनोजोइक एरा आल्सो, इवन ड्यूरिंग द क्वार्टनरी एंड टर्शियरी पीरियड्स आल्सो, दे स्टिल एग्जिस्ट. सी, दिस आर योर ब्रायोफाइट्स. सो ब्रायोफाइट्स हैव successfully established themselves, they have successfully adapted to the prevailing conditions since the Carboniferous period to the Quaternary period of the present day. Right? On the other hand, if you see the link which is coming out between tracheophytes and Brinia-like plants, you can see here the arborescent lycopods grew, but they became extinct in the Permian period of Paleozoic era. है ना? वो आगे नहीं बढ़ पाए. Arborescent lycopods आगे नहीं बढ़ पाए. Whereas herbaceous lycopods अभी भी है. Your fern plants, अपना ferns बोल रही हूँ. Tracheophytes अभी भी है. ये देखो. Herbaceous lycopods. They are still today also they are found. Got it? Fine. How to read this? Now, Rhenia type plants gave rise to coelophyton. Now, as we have already read that ferns, gymnosperms, and horsetails, all of them have evolved from coelophyton. So look at this. Coelophyton एक अकेला है, एक branch, दूसरी branch, तीसरी branch, चौथी branch, पांचवी branch, और ये छठी branch भी coelophyton से ही बनी हुई है. Okay, so see. The first branch which came, it predominantly existed. इधर देखो, ये वाला जो time period है ना, इसका maximum growth या maximum type of these plants called as horsetails were present during the Carboniferous era. ये देखो, maximum है. Devonian age of fish actually, and Carboniferous period, इसमें सबसे ज्यादा ये coelophyton से निकला हुआ horsetails का branch दिख रहा है. Then it became slender, means the population of these horsetails started becoming extinct. But if you see from Triassic period to the current situation, they have maintained their number of species. So Spinopsis horsetails have been maintained till today. Got this? Samajh mein aa gaya? Look at the second branch. The second branch is going to be called as your ferns. Ferns almost uniform throughout. Almost. Okay? Then ginkgos belong to your gymnosperms. Ginkgo biloba, if you remember. Ginkgos couldn't flourish or they couldn't manage to invade the land very nicely till your Permian period. From the Permian period till today, ginkgos have established themselves very nicely. The fourth branch is conifers. See, the conifers could not again develop somewhere up till your Carboniferous period. Now they started becoming very, too many in numbers. But again, in your Cretaceous period onwards, they have become a bit narrower. Okay? Then you can see the nettles. Again, a gymnosperm. Nettles were there since your Devonian period, but they were very much less in numbers. Look at the thinness of this line. Then in your Cretaceous period, they became a bit better in existence and survival. And then again, they have, shrunken a bit, but not like this. So even today, we have got the nettles that are going to be present. Look at it, pro-gymnosperms. Pro-gymnosperms also developed from your coelophyton. Pro-gymnosperms say, maximum pro-gymnosperms were found during the Devonian period. During the Carboniferous period, they became extinct and they evolved to form seeded ferns. Seeded ferns. You remember Selaginella? Precursor to the seed habitat? This is what it is going to be. Selaginella. Okay. Eventually, they gave rise to cycads, that is your cycas plants. And they also gave rise to your angiosperms, that is dicots and monocots. So dicots evolved first during the Cretaceous period and monocots evolved later during the Tertiary period of the Cenozoic era. So dicots ka janam Mesozoic era ka hai aur monocots ka janam Cenozoic era ka hai beta. Though both come under your angiosperms. Is it fine? This is how you have to read this particular diagram and understand this diagram. Have all of you all understood how to read this diagram? Anyone having any difficulty in understanding this diagram? Come on, tell me. Quickly, any difficulty in this? Ferns were more during Jurassic era. They are still there only. Even today they are there. Hai na? Okay, got it? Any difficulty? Any difficulty? Can I move ahead to human beings or animals? Just like plants, how we have seen, let us see, we have evolved from where? Huh? Horsetail lines, see, they are in. Horsetail. Yeah, they are there. They are still there. They are still there. They are almost uniform from your Triassic era onwards. They are almost there. Here. Correct? Yeah, it has become shrunken, but it is still there. Now, this uniformity is maintained. Okay? Well, so, if you look at all these things, what can you say? See, that almost all of them, all these, types of plants were predominantly present during the Carboniferous period. Can you see this? Carboniferous wala era dekho beta. Maximum hai na isme. Isi usko Carboniferous bataya gaya hai. Ye sare jab mar jate the to fossilized hoke hai na. Coal peat aise sab bana dete. Isliye to usko Carboniferous bola gaya. Okay? Now you will be surprised to know something which is actually difficult to उसको हजम करना थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट हो जाता है, बट है तो है, क्या करें. ये देखो बेटा, दिस इज द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव इवोल्यूशनरी हिस्ट्री ऑफ वर्टिब्रेट्स एज दे आर सेइंग थ्रू जियोलॉजिकल टाइम पीरियड. लुक एट इट नाउ, 350 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो, दिस इज योर यू नो एम वाई. 350 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो अर्ली रेप्टाइल्स बिगिन टू बिकम thing. So these are your early reptiles. Okay, so before they could undergo extinction, they, some of them evolved, you know, survival of whom, the fittest, natural selection. So some of them evolved, and as they evolved, they could sustain and regenerate and reproduce to, you know, form their own type of offspring. Okay, so the ones which couldn't adapt to the surviving prevailing conditions, they became extinct. But some evolved, and that evolution caused the formation of two groups. Here you can see sauropsids and synapsids. Okay, so some of these extinct reptiles, they evolved to become sauropsids, and some became synapsids. Idhar tak kahani samjhi, hai na? Now These sauropsids further evolved directly to form your turtles, the current day turtles have evolved from whom? Sauropsids have evolved from whom? Early reptiles. Is it fine? Similarly, sauropsids gave evolutionary line into four parts. So the first part the sauropsids evolved was to form your, who's this, you know the name of this particular organism, theconauts. It gave rise to theconauts. The second line evolved to form Tautaurus. You know who are Tautaurus? Tautaurus pata hai aapko kaun hota hai? Wo टॉटोरस नहीं पता? ये देखो, ये टॉटोरस का फोटो है यहाँ पर. इन मराठी वी कॉल इट घोरपड़. मे बी इगुनास, बट इन मराठी वी कॉल इट घोरपड़. आई नो दैट दैट मूवी इज देयर ना, तानाजी. इन दैट एक्चुअली व्हाट एवर इज शोन इन द मूवी इज अ बिट फॉल्स. इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ शिवाजी महाराज इट्स रिटन दैट तानाजी हैड climbed that fort using these tautaurus. So उन्होंने ना इनके ऊपर ऐसे पकड़ पकड़ के वो पूरी जो मावले थे ना वो चढ़ गए थे. Yes, they used to climb on the backs of this tautaurus. Yes, Siddharth. Yes, my dear. So these are your tautaurus. घोरपड़ कहते हैं उनको मराठी में. Now they are not seen, but still on rocks and all ना, like hill mountains and forts and all, sometimes you can see one or two in those jungles. So even they are there today. Tautaurus is there today. They have not become extinct. So using that, their back was very spiny. So you know, they had these people who used to climb on them now, they had a grip on their back because these walls were very slippery. The walls of those mountains and all used to be very slippery, fort ke walls. So it was very difficult to climb on them. So using these tautaurus now, they used to get the grip and they used to climb over them, and this tautaurus used to form a complete wall on these forts, and they use these tautaurus to use to climb over. Okay, they don't bite and all, they don't do anything, they are not harmful. Okay, so see, so from sauropsids, one line evolved as theconaut, second line evolved as tautaurus, the third line evolved as snake. Okay, look at the line of evolution. And the fourth line evolved as lizards. So lizards, snake, tautaurus, and theconaut. All four have the common ancestor, that is sauropsids. Got it? Understood? Now from tautaurus, from snakes and lizards, no evolution has occurred. But from theconauts, they were now becoming extinct. So they further evolved to form your next group of branching. One which directly has evolved as crocodiles. So can you see this? Crocodiles. So these thecodonts and this crocodile, they have got a much of resemblance because they have evolved from these thecodonts. One line gave as dinosaurs, but before they formed dinosaurs, they also formed this particular one. That is, look at this, look at this, look at this. Birds. So birds also have evolved from the same ancestor called as thecodont. And thecodont is the same one who has developed from sauropsids. And sauropsids is the one who has developed from reptiles. And therefore, we say that birds are glorified reptiles. Okay? So we have said in yesterday's class, day before yesterday, we talked about it. See, that these reptiles are glorified reptiles, which are now known as birds. So birds have evolved from reptiles. How did you understand, beta? Samajh mein aa gaya? So early reptiles made sauropsid. Sauropsid made thecodont. Thecodont gave rise to the birds. Is it okay? Idhar tak kahani samajh mein aa gayi hai? Koi difficulty hai? So sauropsid ne kin kin organisms ko banaya? Dekho. Sauropsid ne turtles banaye, lizards banaye, snakes, tortoises, crocodile, birds, and the extinct ones are dinosaurs and thecodonts. Got it? Clear? Any difficulty with your sauropsids understanding? Look at the second one, synapsids. So these, some of the reptiles, they evolved as synapsids. Synapsids gave rise to Pelycosaurus, which became extinct. The ones which survived were called as Therapsids. They also became extinct. The ones which survived and evolved eventually were called as mammals. So mammals ka jo evolutionary tree hai, wo bahut zyada branching wala hai nahi beta. Hai na? Ye dekho. Synapsids to Pelycosaurus, Pelycosaurus to Therapsids, and Therapsids to mammals. So there is no branching over here. They have directly, synapsids have, वैसे देखा जाए तो directly given rise to mammals. So evolved Pelycosaurus is synapsids, evolved Therapsids is Pelycosaurus, and evolved mammals are Therapsids. Understood? So हमारे जो ancestors है ना, वो भी reptiles है. लिजर्ड के एंसेस्टर्स भी रेप्टाइल्स है, क्रोकोटाइल के एंसेस्टर्स भी रेप्टाइल्स है, बर्ड्स के एंसेस्टर्स भी रेप्टाइल्स है, डायनासोर के एंसेस्टर्स भी रेप्टाइल्स है. मतलब देखिए बेटा, अगर हम बॉटम लाइन देखते हैं तो क्या समझ में आता है? वी ऑल आर वन ना, वी ऑल हैव डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम द सेम ग्रुप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स कॉल्ड एज रेप्टाइल्स. इजंट इट, इजंट इट? Seems to be very odd, as I said in the beginning only. कुछ चीजें हजम होने के लिए बहुत difficult है, but it has been proven about it that even we have developed, mammals also have evolved via the reptiles only. Oh my God, आज रात को नींद आएगी ना तुम लोग को? यही सोचते रहोगे, मेरे बाजू में lizard आया, सो जा बेटा. एक time पे हम लोग एक ही type के ancestor से पैदा हुए हैं, हाँ? ऐसे करोगे? That's a fact. And it is not just mentioned, it is not just imaginary, it is proven, my dears, because science needs proof. And all these proofs have been found out by the geologists and the paleontologists. So this is a proven, tested and proven part of our human evolution, mammal evolution as well. So this interesting. Any difficulty? Sauropsids क्या है, synopsids क्या है, dinosaurs किसके ascendant है, crocodile किसका ascendant है, lizard किसका ascendant है, किसी को कोई doubt है इसमें? Any difficulty? Can I move ahead? Oh, fine. Yeah. So now let us understand कि ये जो evolve हुए और ये जैसे adapt हुए, so how was this adaptation possible? Okay, कैसे adaptations carry out होते गए आगे आगे, वो देखना है. ये देखिए, adaptive radiations. The process of evolution, which results in transformation of original species to many different varieties, is called as adaptive radiation. So just now you saw that sauropsid alone has radiated into so many different types of varieties. Correct? Right? Something like that. But Darwin had studied them in a different way. Darwin's finches represent one of the best examples of the phenomena. Darwin observed small black birds on his voyage to Galapagos Island. Later, it was called as Darwin's finches. He realized that there were many varieties of finches in the same island. From the original seed-eating features, many other forms with altered beaks arose, enabling them to become insectivorous and vegetarian finches as well. So look at the shape of their beak. Look at this. These are the different types of finches that he has observed. So look at the shape of the beak. The beaks have got adapted for eating. Okay. So that they can feed on either insects or seeds. Seed ke liye they require pointed one. Hai na? For picking up an insect, they require a broader type of a beak. So all these are your evolved beaks ke finches. Small birds in. If you see over here, see here very beautifully they have given the shape. You can see this large ground finch which is eating or feeding on seed. Okay, look at it. It is shorter and it is pointed. This is cactus ground finch which feeds on the cactus roots and flowers. So look at the length of the beak, right? It is long so that it can, you know, actually put its beak slender and long, right? Inside, and it can feed on it. Vegetarian finch, which feeds on buds. Okay, look at the size of it. It is still more shorter. And woodpecker finch, which eats insects. So see, look at the type of the beak, how it has evolved, so that it can catch hold perfectly of the insects also like this, right? So these are all your adaptive radiations, examples of adaptive radiations of Darwinian finches. In the same way, another example of adaptive radiation is going to be Australian marsupials, which we call them as pouched animals. A number of marsupials, each different from one another, evolved from an ancestral stock, but all within the Australian island continent itself. So everyone got, you know, became different from each other, but in that same island, Australia mein hi ye sare ke sare aaj bhi milte hai hame. When more than one adaptive radiation appeared to have occurred in an isolated geographical area, one can call this as convergent evolution. So it is not diverging to all the different continents. It is only in one of the continents. And it is, you know, like what we say, endemic to that particular area. Udhar hi ye milte hai. Udhar hi inka diversification hua hai. Usi area mein ye log evolve hue hai. Okay. So ye jo organisms hai na, wo all over the world aur kahi nahi milenge. So they are convergent. Okay. So what is convergent evolution? Understand again, one more time I'm repeating. When more than one adaptive radiation appeared to have occurred in an isolated geographical area, okay, representing different habitats, one can call this as convergent evolution. Best example is Australian marsupials. They all belong to Australia only. So see, adaptive radiation of marsupials of Australia, which is showing convergent evolution. Kya kya evolve hai dekho? Marsupial radiations dekho. This is in Australia. Wombat, bandicoot, koala, marsupial mole, sugar glider, Tasmanian wolf, tiger cat. This is going to be your banded anteater, marsupial rat, and kangaroo. All are going to be from the same pouched animal and they all have evolved, but they are not found in any other part of the world, only in a particular secluded area. Therefore, it is an example of adaptive radiation plus convergent evolution. अंडरस्टूड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू? एडाप्टिव है. एडाप्टिव रेडिएशन का मतलब क्या होता है कि एक फॉर्म से दूसरे फॉर्म में ऐसे वैरायटीज बनना, टू अडैप्ट टू द प्रिवेलिंग कंडीशन, उसको हम कहते हैं एडाप्टिव रेडिएशन. रेडिएट होना मतलब ओरिजिनल फॉर्म से हटना, ओरिजिनल फॉर्म से डिविएट होना, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज रेडिएशन. वाई हटना, वाई डिविएट होना? सो दैट दे गेट अडैप्टेड टू द प्रिवेलिंग कंडीशन. बट इफ इट इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर मेनी डिफरेंट वैरायटीज का रेडिएशन इन अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया ओनली, इट इज ज्योग्राफिकल एवोल्यूशन के हिसाब से कन्वर्जेंट एवोल्यूशन. अंडरस्टूड? एनी डिफिकल्टी इन दिस बेटा? एनीवन नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस पार्ट? ऑल ऑफ यू? नाउ इफ यू लुक एट द डायग्राम, ये शुगर ग्लाइडर कहाँ, ये कंगारू कहाँ, ये ताजमेनियन वुल्फ तो और भी अलग लग रहा है, कोआला कितना क्यूट सा है, ये मार्सुपियन मोल देखो कितना छोटा है, बट दे ऑल आर मार्सुपियल्स. They all are marsupials. They all are pouched animals only, beta. Okay? Got it? ये वुम्बैट तो बेर के जैसे दिखता है हमें. Yeah. So, placental mammals in Australia also exhibit adaptive radiation and evolving into varieties such as placental mammals, each of which appear to be similar to the corresponding marsupial. So, ये देखो, ये Australian marsupials है. और ये प्लेसेंटल मैमल्स है विच आर फाउंड एनीवेयर. ओके, सो इट इज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ योर कन्वर्जेंट एवोल्यूशन फॉर दिस ऑस्ट्रेलियन मार्सुपियल. मोल, ये मार्सुपियल मोल, प्लेसेंटल मैमल इज नॉर्मल मोल. नुम्बैट एंटीटर, लेसर एंटीटर. मार्सुपियल माउस, नॉर्मल माउस. स्पॉटेड कस्टस, लेमूर्स. फ्लाइंग फलेंजर और शुगर ग्लाइडर एज वी से, फ्लाइंग स्क्विरल. Tasmanian wolf or Tasmanian tiger cat, ocelot. Tasmanian wolf, your normal wolf. So, these Australian marsupials are showing convergent evolution, right? But there are placental mammals found all over the world which look like these, which resemble these. Okay? Got it? Understood? So, in different continents, or in different areas of the geographical scales, we can find all these animals here and there, and they are showing much resemblance to the Australian marsupial. So they appear to be similar to the corresponding marsupial is what they are saying. So these are not pouched, these are not marsupials, these are placental mammals which resemble the Australian marsupials. Did you understand this? Okay. Yeah. So what is? Huh? Ask me your doubt. What it is? Clear your doubt, beta. Poocho, poocho. It is this one. Your flying squirrel. It's like your flying squirrel. Okay. Anyone else having any difficulty with understanding of this? So they are saying Australia has seen maximum adaptive radiations with respect to the pouched animals also and with respect to the placental mammals also. But these placental mammals are not only and only found in Australia. They can be found anywhere else as well. Is it okay? Clear? Okay. Well, then we come to the biological evolution part. Evolution by natural selection in true sense would have started when cellular forms of life with differences in metabolic capability originated on the earth. What's your doubt? So that we can say that after separation into continents, some reptiles evolved into yes, and they form particular adaptation. Yes, my dear. You're right. Bilkul sahi samjhe ho. That is what, one got evolved, one did not. That is the story of evolution. One evolved, one got adapted. Selection of the fittest. Okay, yeah. Now, they are saying under biological evolution, they are saying evolution by natural selection in true sense would have started when cellular forms of life with differences in metabolic capability originated on Earth. Correct? Correct. Only then one, the best one would be selected. The rate of appearance of new forms is linked to the life cycle or the lifespan. Microbes that divide fast have the ability to multiply fast and become millions of individuals within hours. Take the example of corona. Coronavirus capable of dividing very fast, and therefore they become millions of millions within few hours, right? A colony of bacteria, say A, growing on a given medium has built-in variation in terms of ability to utilize feed component. A change in the medium composition would bring out only that part of the population, say B, that can survive under new conditions. So there's one petri dish containing nutrient agar, okay? And we are growing bacteria on it, fine? So this is your plate A, okay? Second plate also contains nutrient agar, but it is going to contain an antibiotic like penicillin, for example, okay? Again, I try to grow the same group of bacteria on this plate also. Now, what I observe after 24 hours is the plate without penicillin, there is a dense growth of bacteria on that plate. While the plate which was containing penicillin has got fewer colonies, lesser colonies of bacteria. But what can I conclude from that? That these which can grow even in the presence of the antibiotic penicillin are resistant to penicillin. So these have evolved to get adapted to the penicillin antibiotic. Okay, so a new evolved species of penicillin resistant varieties have been grown on this plate. Agreed what I said? Understood what I said? So ek bata petri dish hai, usme sirf humne bacteria ka food dala hai. Dusra hai jisme bacteria ka food bhi hai aur bacteria ko kill karne wala poison bhi hai. To jiske upar food sirf dala hai, udhar to maximum 200 colonies grow ho gayi bacteria ki. लेकिन इसके ऊपर सिर्फ 10 कॉलोनीज ग्रो हो गई. ठीक है, 10 हो गई मतलब ये जो 10 है दे हैव इवॉल्व्ड टू गेट अडैप्टेड टू पेनिसिलिन एंड दस दे आर मोर अडैप्टेड एंड मोर सूटेड टू सस्टेन एंड सर्वाइव. गॉट इट? समझ में आ गई बात? सो दैट इज व्हाट दे आर सेइंग. सो सपोज ए दे आर सेइंग इज गोइंग टू बी योर normal one wherein the feed component has been added. In B, if we change the composition or we bring about some changes, then lesser one will develop, but they will develop. So in due course of time, the variant B outgrows the A and appears as new species. This is the beauty. So ek bar wo adapt ho gaya na beta, to fir wo aram se jab jab bhi aap usko penicillin doge na, tab tabhi bhi wo log mast grow karenge. उनको कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. They'll outpower the A species. Okay? This would happen in days for bacteria, but it would take millions of years for a fish or a fowl, as the lifespan of these animals is in years. So more is the lifespan, more time would be taken for evolution. Less is the time span, quickly the evolution would take place. Understood the point of discussion here? So here we say that the fitness of B is better than A under new conditions. So all those who have already survived the first wave of corona, second wave of corona, are more better fitted to sustain and survive in the new conditions. Get me? Nature selects for fitness. This fitness is based on characteristics which are inherited. Hence, there must be genetic basis for getting selected and to evolve. Of course, there is going to be genetic, mode of survival only if the genes are able to produce the natural immunogens against the prevailing conditions. We are going to survive, right? Adaptive ability is inherited. So this ability will eventually be passed on to the next generation. As I said, in 1919, there was Spanish flu. Now we are not going to be affected ever because of that, because that immunity that came in our great grandparents or so on was passed on generation after generation, which was an adapted immunity. Okay, so it's an adapted ability which is passed on from generation to the next. So we all will not be never affected by the Spanish flu. Understood this part? This is what I was talking about, how antibiotic resistance develops. Just see, antibiotic helps our bodies to kill the types of bacteria that make us sick, correct? Some of the bacteria that make us sick get better at defending themselves against antibiotic, meaning resistant bacteria are harder to kill. This is called as antibiotic resistance. The resistant bacteria they start to multiply, making our antibiotics less and less effective. Okay, so this is how they are saying that here, when they are adding the antibiotic, ek bande ko infection hua hai, bacterial infection hua hai, usne jab medicine le liya, to wo jo medicine jaisi andar uske cells mein chala gaya, to kya ho gaya beta? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bacteria kill ho gaye. लेकिन एक बैक्टीरिया ने रेजिस्टेंस दिखा दिया. अब ये एक बैक्टीरिया जो है ना, वो काफी है एक के दो, दो के चार थोड़े ही समय में बनाने के लिए, इन स्पाइट ऑफ द एंटीबायोटिक कमिंग. इट इज नाउ रेजिस्टेंट, सो इट विल आउटग्रो द ओरिजिनल फॉर्म. ओके, सो इसीलिए है ना, मैंने उस दिन भी आपको बताया, डोंट कंज्यूम टू मच ऑफ पिल्स विदाउट रीजन. That was the main reason that I was talking about. ये ऐसी चीज हो जाती है फिर हमारे बॉडी. How beautifully they have explained, na? Okay. Is evolution a process or is it a consequence? Branching, descent, and natural selection are the two key concepts of Darwinian theory of evolution. Branching, descent means sauropsids giving rise to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, है ना? So that is going to be called as your branching descendant. And after that, the best one will be selected. As Chicodont was not selected, dinosaurs not selected. Eventually, you know, crocodiles selected. So not only the branching descendants, but their natural selection is also important. So these are the two important, you know, for your concepts put forward by Darwin. The world we see inanimate and animate is only the success stories of evolution. Yes, of course. Evolve hue, naturally select ho gaye, tick gaye. Hai na? When we describe the story of the world, we describe evolution as a process. On the other hand, when we describe the story of life on the earth, we treat evolution as a consequence of a process. Okay? And the process ka naam is nothing but natural selection. So what we say, इधर से इधर इवॉल्व हो गया, इससे वो इवॉल्व हो गया, उससे वो इवॉल्व हो गया, इट्स अ प्रोसेस, करेक्ट? बट वो इवॉल्व होके सस्टेन हुआ बिकॉज ऑफ नेचुरल सिलेक्शन इज अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस. ओके, इवॉल्व हुआ और सस्टेन हुआ बिकॉज ऑफ नेचुरल सिलेक्शन. गॉट इट? राइट. सो द वर्क ऑफ थॉमस मालथियस ऑन पॉपुलेशन इन्फ्लुएंस्ड डार्विन. Natural selection is based on certain observations which are factual. They are facts. Okay, there are no derivations to it. These are facts. For example, natural resources are limited. Populations are stable in size except for the seasonal fluctuations. Members of population vary in characteristics. Even though superficially they look similar, most of the variations are inherited. Okay, so they look similar, but they have evolved, right? For example, winters would approach, you will see a steep rise in mosquito populations. Your rainy season would appear, jaise rainy season start ho jayega, you would see a steep increase in the number of flies. Bahut zyada makkhi aati hai ya nahi? Bahut zyada makkhi aati hai beta. rainy season mein. So according to the seasonal variations, one particular population will increase. It will show a steep rise, right? Right? Though they appear almost similar, they are evolved. They are, changing internally. Their genetic makeup is not the same, is what is being said over here, right? In fact, that the theoretical population size will grow exponentially if everybody reproduces maximally. And the fact that population sizes become limited means that there had been competition for resources, right or wrong? So ये जो एक population एकदम increase होता है flies का, all of a sudden जैसे ही बारिश चला जाता है या कम हो जाता है, इनका population decline होने लगता है. How does the population decline all of a sudden? How the population increases all of a sudden? So it is going to be competition for the same resources. They are dependent. अभी suppose I am telling you for example. आपके घर पे आप लोग चार लोग रहते हो, करेक्ट? आपके घर पे एवरी डे लेके चलिए कि आज अभी आज के दिन की मैं बात करूं तो आज आपके घर पे मम्मा ने गुलाब जामुन बनाया, ठीक है? फॉर एग्जाम्पल आप चार लोग हो, है ना, 20 गुलाब जामुन बनाए हैं सुबह शाम लेकर, चलो भाई चार पांच खाएंगे सब लोग मिलके, करेक्ट? Agreed? Sure. So there is no limitation. You can eat 5 4 are 20, correct? But all of a sudden आपके घर पे गेस्ट आ गए, है ना? आपके घर पे गेस्ट आ गए, इमेजिन कर लो 6 गेस्ट आ गए आपके घर पे, अब क्या हो गया? 20 divided by 10, 2 to each, right? So when the number of individuals would increase, when the amount of individuals would increase, what would happen? Competition for resources. So when there were say 100 flies, the food that seemed to be available was abundant. But when 100 became 1 lakh, the food was that much only. But now the population of these flies have increased so much na, that now that food ke liye kya ho gaya? Competition. Right, got it now. So this is what is we are talking about right now, correct? So see, so the fact that theoretically population size will grow exponentially if everyone will reproduce maximally, and the fact that population size will get limited means that there had been competition for resources. Yes, Devang, very nice. Yes, this is the main reason. Yes, very correct. Only some survived and grew at the cost of others that couldn't flourish. So when there was competition, what happened? One was successful, other was unsuccessful. So one got naturally selected, other got naturally eliminated. Right? The novelty and the brilliant insight of Darwin was this. He asserted that variations which are heritable and which will make resource utilization better for few, the ones who have adapted, will enable only those to reproduce and leave more progeny, while the other will automatically get eliminated from the race. Okay? Hence, for a period of time, over many generations, survivors will leave more progeny, and there would be change in population, population characteristics, and hence the new forms appear to be evolved. Okay, and they will arise as evolved species. This process is called as speciation. So what is speciation, beta? Those particular group of populations which have adapted and evolved to sustain and survive in the prevailing condition is speciation. Did you all understand what is speciation? Got this? Clear? Yeah. So this is evolution is a process, or it's a consequence, is what we have understood today. Anyone who has not followed any part of this, my dears? Anyone? now to wind up with today's class, but the most important point, the most important part is Hardy Weinberg's principle. Of course, this will be taught to you all by certain principles of inheritance as well, but it's a part of our syllabus of this thing also, evolution also. But if you don't understand this, you will not understand anything. And it's a mathematical calculation. Questions every year are going to be asked on a particular formula. You have to use this formula and find out the answer. Okay. So what is Hardy-Weinberg's principle? I won't start today because I want all of you all to be very fresh. And I want you all to understand this concept very precisely. I'll be giving you all some practice sums to do so that you can master this. Okay, so for today I'll stop. I want in continuation to be taught for this particular topic. So I won't go ahead with Hardy-Weinberg today. I'll talk about Hardy-Weinberg in the next class. Fine. So whatever I have talked till today, have you all understood very nicely? Anyone who has not followed any part of it, beta? Well, so in the next class, we will complete this chapter. Evolution will be completed in the next class. Fine. And then we can go ahead with a new topic. So evolution next class mein khatam ho jayega. Is it fine? Chalo. Bye, beta. See you all. Have a nice day and take care.